can't understand it. She seemed so friendly and glad to see me at first, and then when I went back with the butter, she just grabbed it and practically slammed the door in my face.
Well, what do you care? If you want my advice, you'll forget about her. She gets up too early anyway.
The whole thing doesn't make any sense. Why should she change like that all of a sudden?
Well, beats me. You didn't even find out her name, did you?
Well, no, but at least I know where she lives.
Well, what good is that going to do?
Well, I can go over there this afternoon and find out what happened.
Well, you could have done that this morning.
I know, but this whole thing took me by surprise. I didn't know what to do.
Hi, fellas.
Hi, Mark.
How'd everything go this morning?
Oh, pretty good.
I sure want to thank you guys for helping me out like this.
Oh, that's okay.
We enjoyed it.
Say, Harv, what's the name of that girl who lives over on Maple Street?
Maple Street?
Yeah, you know, the good-looking blonde with the blue eyes.
Please, I'm a married man.
She lives at 713 Maple.
That's the Wilson's house. But Mrs. Wilson is hardly what you'd call a good-looking blonde.
Well, this girl said something about her aunt. She must be Mrs. Wilson's niece.
Well, I've never seen her. Maybe she's just visiting. Why?
Oh, nothing. I was just wondering.
Hey, Mrs. Wilson's one of my best customers. Nothing happened, did it?
Oh, no. I'll see you later, Harv.
Say, Harv, you can't think of any reason why that girl would slam the door in Rick's face, can you?
No, I can't.
Oh, it was probably nothing. I'll see you later.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hey, you guys.
Well, here we are.
Yeah, here we are.
Well, just tell me one thing. What am I doing here with you?
Well, you're here to give me moral support and make any intelligent suggestions you might think of. That sounds ridiculous just saying.
Well, the first thing you got to do is get out of the car.
Well, I got to figure out what to say to her, don't I? Well, how does this sound?
Well, that doesn't sound very good. Why don't you say, duh,
That's very funny. Look, wait till I get started, will you?
Hey, did you say she was a good-looking blonde?
Well, you better hurry. There you go.
Hey, wait a minute.
You want to get arrested or something?
Look, will you turn the car around before we lose her?
This is it. She must be around here someplace.
Well, come on. Let's start looking for her.
We have no idea where she went. Why don't we just wait here till she gets back?
Hey, here's an idea. Let's lock bumpers with her car. That'll give you a chance to talk with her before she drives off. You stand on the edge of the bumper and I'll drive forward.
Okay, but I'm not sure this is such a good idea. Two chocolate milks.
Coming right up.
We can drive out to her house again. Yeah, that is, if you're that interested.
Oh, I suppose this whole thing's kind of silly. The ridiculous part of it is, here I am chasing a girl all over town, and I don't even know her name.
Well, we know where she lives. As I say, we could drive back out to her house again.
Oh, let's forget about it. You gotta be a fatalist about these things. If I was supposed to see the girl again, I would.
Well, okay. I was just trying to give you the benefit of my years of experience in matters of this sort.
Pretty nice, huh?
What's that?
That blonde that just walked out. You guys must be slipping.
What blonde?
Right out there, getting into the red sports car.
Red sports car? Hey, that's the girl. Come on, give me the keys to your car, quick. Well, come on. I got him here someplace. Go ahead, maybe you can catch her. Oh, hi.
Oh, it's you.
Can I talk to you for a minute?
About what?
Well, I want to know what happened.
What do you mean, what happened?
Well, at first you seemed so friendly, and then you practically slammed the door in my face.
I'm sorry if I was rude. Is that all you wanted to tell me?
Well, no. Actually, I wanted to invite you to a party tomorrow night.
Well, thank you very much. But I think it'd be much nicer if you stayed home with your wife and children.
Children? Hey, wait a second. I don't have a wife and children. Well, gee, Rick, I didn't know you were coming back. I drank your malt.
Well, never mind that. Just give me the keys to your car, quick.
You mean she got away again?
Well, yeah, but at least I know why she's been avoiding me. She thinks I'm married.
Well, what ever gave her that idea?
Well, I don't know. Come on, give me the keys.
And I left them on the table.
Hey, what's this all about, anyway?
Well, I was delivering milk for a couple of mornings, and I met this good-looking girl.
You mean the blonde that was just in here?
Yeah.
Here, catch.
What the heck do you think you're doing?
Hey, how about that? Did you see that shot?
Yeah, we saw it. Now, how am I going to get the keys out of there?
Here, hold this. I'll get a spoon.
Well, there's only one thing for me to do. It won't be easy, but anything for a friend. Where are the keys? Don't tell me I swallowed them.
You know darn well they're in the vanilla mall.
Here, I'll get them.
Thanks, Jack.
Yeah, okay. Here, you might as well drink this one, too.
Oh, thanks, Jack, but I don't like vanilla.
It's on the house.
Oh, well, why didn't you say so?
Hey.
Oh, hi.
Where are you going?
Well, I was trying to catch you. Were you looking for me?
Well, yes. What did you mean before when you said you didn't have a wife and children?
Just what I said. I'm not married.
You're not?
No. What made you think I was?
Well, your Christmas card, it said, Merry Christmas from you and your wife and your children.
Oh, that wasn't for me. I was just delivering that for Harvey. Now, I'm not the regular milkman. I was just helping him out for a couple of days.
And you're not Harvey Mitchell?
Well, no, I'm Ricky Mitchell. Ricky Nelson.
Oh, for goodness sakes.
Oh, what's your name?
I'm Laurie Wilson.
You're not married, are you?
No, I'm not. In fact, I don't know anybody in town. I'm just here visiting my aunt for a few weeks.
Oh. Say, I hope you don't think I'm rushing things, but what are you doing tomorrow night?
I have a date.
You do?
Yes, with you, I hope.
Oh, you sure have.
Set my soul on fire, ever loving, I'll be ever loving you. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Ever loving, I will treat you tender. Ever loving, if you will surrender. Ever loving, I'll be ever loving you. Whoa, whoa. You're my darling, the only one I'm dreaming of. I gotta make you mine. You're the only one I'll ever love. Ever love and say you leave me never. Ever love and I'll be yours forever. Ever love and I'll be ever loving you.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Ever love and I'll be ever loving you.
Thanks.
Have you been singing long?
Oh, for quite a while. Actually, we're sort of a musical family. My father plays the banjo.
Oh, really?
No, I...
Time for refreshments. Come on, everybody.
Oh, that's why I'm here.
Well, you didn't have to panic. I really wasn't going to play.
I wasn't taking any chances.
I got it. Hello? Oh, hi, Harv. How's everything? Oh, gee, that's too bad. Well, yeah, I'll ask him. And if he can't do it, I'm sure Wally can. Now, don't worry about it. We'll take care of it some way. Just a second. Harriet, It's Harvey on the phone. He wants to know if the boys can take over for him again tomorrow morning. Rick, Harvey's on the phone. He's got a real bad cold, and he wants to know if you can take over the milk route again for him tomorrow morning.
Gee, Pop, we're going skiing tomorrow morning.
Wally, too?
Well, yeah, Wally, Dave, Charlie, the whole gang of us.
I promised him somebody to help him out.
Well, don't look at me.
What are you doing tomorrow morning, Pop?
Harv, yeah, I found somebody. Oh, good morning.
Well, good morning. Are you the new milkman?
No, I'm just substituting for him. Well, goodbye.
What's the hurry?
Well, I have quite a few deliveries to make. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good morning.
Good morning. I haven't seen you before. You're kind of cute.
Thank you. I'm really not. I'm married. In fact, I have two small boys at home. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Oh, good morning.
Well, hello there, honey. I haven't seen you before.
No, I'm new. You see, I'm not a real milkman. I'm just temporary.
Well, don't stand out here in the cold. Come on in and have a cup of coffee.
Oh, well, thank you, but it's against company regulation.
Oh, don't be silly. Come on.
Cut it out. I guess I must have been dreaming.
You better get dressed. Getting pretty late.
Well, you didn't have to get up. What are you dressed for?
Well, you don't think I'm going to let you go alone, do you? With all those beautiful girls? Come on, get dressed. I'll put the coffee on.
You think maybe I talk in my sleep?